First and foremost, this license must be assigned before software is used. Why it's important? You have people working from home. You work in a company. There's 1,000 people. They have 1,000 company devices and maybe other devices that may use to access company service through VPN. They work from home because of COVID. If you do not restrict access to software that they access through your VPN to a certain limited number of devices or users, depending on the type of the license, then you need to buy licenses for them all. If it's a user license, for all these 1,000 users. If it's a device license, God knows how many device licenses, 4,000, 5,000, how many devices they have at home, their tablets, laptops, and whatnot. Even if only 10 users really use it, they have a theoretical possibility to connect to that server from their device. They're not restricted. And the second they do that, they will be violating these fundamental rights because the license is not yet assigned to them. There's no license yet. This is why you need to license for the maximum number of virtual machines on the host, because licenses must be assigned before the virtual machine moves to that host. So license must be always assigned first, not just dropped somewhere, before it may be used, before you may use the software. Where do you assign licenses? So in the Microsoft world, there are three areas where you assign licenses. User licenses are assigned to users. What is a user? In Microsoft licensing world, a user is a person, one person. If that person has multiple accounts, they need one license, usually, if it's a user license. It's me, with all my avatars, just one me. You assign a user license to me or to yourself. Device license, that could be a computer, could be a phone, could be what Microsoft defines as hardware partition, a piece of hardware. And server is, although we put it in a separate bucket here, although license server is defined, the only difference between device and server in the Microsoft definitions, it's a device running server software. That's a server. That doesn't make all devices servers, but it makes all servers devices from the Microsoft licensing point of view. Where not to assign licenses, one of the mistakes lots of people make, and even a colleague of mine, very good friend of mine today said, like, why can't I assign license to which machine? What about SQL Server? You may calculate requirements per virtual machine, but the license is still assigned to this hardware server, not virtual, hardware server, where that VM is currently sitting. Licenses are not assigned to virtual machines. If you want to argue with me, send me a quote from the product terms. We can discuss it. Where else? Connections. There's no such metric as connection. So Microsoft doesn't have a metric called connection. You don't license connections. When the license is assigned, it must stay where it's assigned for 90 days with the two exceptions. Exceptional circumstances. User is sick. Then you may reassign user account to someone temporarily. Device is broken beyond repair. You may reassign the license, if it's a reassignable license, not OEM, to a different device. These are exceptional circumstances. This rule of 90 days, and I'll explain to you shortly how, may also be waived by applying certain rights through software assurance. But then again, I'd like you to understand two things which are fundamental for understanding virtualization. License is always assigned to a host, and it must stay with the host for 90 days. That is the default rule. What virtualization is? You may know physical computers. That's your majority of the laptops, majority of either home devices. It's just a physical layer. Use a specific software called Hypervisor. You may also create pretend computers that will be running on your computer, but they will kind of pretend to the software that they are the computers. You run an operating system, your Windows, and then you create another virtual machine with Windows, which thinks it's a separate machine, but running on the same hardware. These are virtual machines. They don't run directly on the hardware. They run through a specific layer called Hypervisor. You always have one physical operating system and may have from zero to virtual operating systems on one hardware host. This hardware, from the virtualization point of view, is called a host. Multiple hosts create a cluster. This is a so-called virtualization cluster. Multiple hardware servers running virtual machines in them. Look at the licenses that I put on this picture. So the licenses in the bottom row, these are the licenses for operating systems at the physical level. You may notice that on the leftmost host, there are two virtual machines, and I assigned two licenses for some hypothetical software that runs on these virtual machines. I assigned it to the host, not to the virtual machines, because you may not assign it to virtual machines. And I assigned one license to one VM on the second host. The whole purpose of clustering is resource allocation and reacting to, say, one host broke. So then other hosts in the cluster, they take that workload on them. VMs move like this, so they move around. So what just happened? Two virtual machines moved to the third host, then one came back. The third host is now not properly licensed. It's not compliant because the VM is not licensed. And there's an extra license on the first host, but it may not move to the third one for 90 days. So right now, because they moved around, it's called vMotion, virtual machine mobility. It can have various acronyms like HADRS-DR. To simplify this, we call it virtual machine mobility. We have mobile virtual machines. That's the whole purpose, to have a virtual cluster. So right now, we are not correctly licensed. licensed. We need that license from the host number one to move to the host number three. We need it to move to be compliant. How do we do that? We should have bought these licenses with software assurance. The right that allows you, permits you to move licenses in real time is called license mobility in server farms. Pay attention, it doesn't apply to all the products. It must be expressly granted to a specific product. Where do you check that? In the product list. Find the product and see if it has license mobility in server farms. So SQL Server, does it have it? Go to the product terms, find it. Yes, it does. Windows Server, go to the product terms and find that it doesn't have the license mobility in server farms. Okay, I've got lots of questions about virtualization. I'd like to answer them. As you said, we can't assign license for VM, but we can assign license from cost optimization point of view. No, you can't assign it to the virtual machine. You can calculate it for the VM, but you have to assign it to the host. If we migrate VM to another server, do we need license or it will be moved? So if you kill that server, that probably is one of those exceptional instances when you can move licenses. But if you're just migrating it from a server to a server, then you need to move the license. Then the question is, this is a good one. Then the question is, for how long did that license stay on that initial server? If for more than 90 days, yes, you can move it. If less than 90 days, you have to wait until 90 days expire, then you can move it. Or if you have software assurance, you can move it at any time. If the product has license mobility in server farms, how do you assign a license? That's not always stipulated. So for online services, it's simple. You know, Office 365, you assign licenses to some account in your admin console. When it's not Office 365, then it's not really stipulated. It's up to you. You can have a software asset management tool, Snow, Flexera, Spera, SAMPro, Zen, some software asset management tool, or CMDB, where you may assign licenses, you assign them there. That's one of the ways. You just need to formally assign license to something. It could be an Excel spreadsheet, or I've seen it in small companies, licenses were just assigned on paper. Microsoft does not stipulate how your register of licenses should be maintained.